Monsieur le vice-président de l'Académie des sciences, madame la secrétaire perpétuelle, chers consoeurs, chers confrères, chers collègues, mesdames et messieurs, it is a pleasure to welcome you to this colloquium on symbiosis and cohabitation. I was wondering, in fact, if this word was really English. In France, the word cohabitation has been used to designate a situation where the president and the government have different political colors. For those who do not know that, I hope we won't have such situations in the near future. It will be interesting to see what is being meant in the present context. We have five presentations during this morning and four others this afternoon, followed by a general discussion. This interesting and timely program was designed by Pascal Cossard, Michel Delceni, he is here, and Bernard Dujon, who is down there, with the contribution of our colleague from the Académie Française, Eric Orsena. Many thanks to Eric Orsena for being with us today. He's very interested in the subject, and he will tell us a few words after. At this stage, may I express the wish that we closely follow the schedule. Each talk should not exceed 30 minutes. Please be kind enough to stick with the time allocated to you. For that, there is a little white light that will tell you that you are 20 minutes. This is just for the speakers. After the starting time, and the red light will indicate that you should stop at 25 minutes so that we can handle a few questions from the audience. Pascal Cossard will briefly introduce the subject, then Eric Orsena will continue, and Michel Delceni will introduce the speakers. Thank you.
Okay, so it's a great pleasure for me to introduce this colloquium, which is at the crossroads between ecology, human and animal health, and also nutrition. So our knowledge of the interactions between various organisms, including plants and microorganisms, has dramatically increased in recent years, thanks to all the new cutting-edge technologies such as metagenomics, transcriptomics, metabolomics, and also cell biology. So the three sections of biology of the Academy are happy to have successfully assembled a great program today. So the society is well aware of the importance of the role of symbiotic relationships, and everybody has heard about the intestinal microbiota and its key role in health and disease, and this will be the focus of this afternoon. But much less people are aware of the role of symbiosis in the environment, of the role of insects in all kinds of processes. But there are individuals such as Eric Orsena who are able to create bridges between scientists and the lay public. And Eric, thank you for coming and co-chairing the first session. And before leaving you the stage, I would like to briefly present the Academy to those who do not know it, especially our foreign speakers. So the Académie des Sciences is one of the five academies which are hosted in the Institut de France. So you see we have the Académie Française, and the secrétaire perpétuelle is Hélène Carrère-Dancos, Académie des Inscriptions et Belles Lettres with Michel Zinc as secrétaire perpétuelle. At the Académie des Sciences, we have two divisions, one which is including mathematics and physics, and the secrétaire perpétuelle is Catherine Bréchignac, and the second division is including chemistry, biology, and medicine, and I am the secrétaire perpétuelle. So the Académie des Beaux-Arts is having a new secrétaire perpétuelle, Laurent Petit-Gérard, and Académie des Sciences Morales et Politiques as secrétaire perpétuelle, Jean-Robert Pitt. You see that there are presidents for four of these academies. So our academy has 258 members, including 28 new women, 130 foreign associates, and 84 corresponding members. So they are elected by the members of the academy among French and foreign scientists. So beside the president, the vice president, and the two secrétaires perpétuels, the board includes one delegate for international affairs, Catherine Cesarski, one delegate for scientific information and communication, Alain-Jacques Valeron, and one delegate for education and training, and this is Eric Westhoff. So the two divisions, I already said what they were, including mathematics, physics, mechanics, and computer science are thirds for division one, and for division two, chemistry, biology, integrative biology, human biology, and medical science. And we have a cross section, an intersection, which includes a lot of applied sciences. So we have a lot of committees, working groups to explore ideas and make proposals. So this is an independent institution which is placed under the protection of the President de la République. So it's free to draw its own conclusions, opinions, and reports. And it was reformed in 2002 to meet the evolution of science and technology. So we somehow changed the section divisions, the division in different sections, or changed the names, and also to rejuvenate the membership. So when we have elections, if we have elections for, let's say, two members per section, one member should be under 55. So this has really made a lot of changes in our academy. And the academy is performing five missions to support scientific progress. So the first is to encourage the scientific community by first recognizing the best researchers, by awarding prizes and medals. We organize colloquia, like this one. We publish compte rendu de l'Académie des sciences. Originally, they were to report about what happened during the sessions. We have more, like a normal reporting journals where you can publish your original articles. So the second mission is to impart knowledge by organizing sessions open to the lay public. More and more our sessions, in fact, are open to the lay public. We want to disseminate the scientific culture via different tools, a website, biannual letter. We have with the young people, young school students, a session which is called Speed Science. And we have different activities, and you can go to the website, which is more and more documented to really increase the knowledge in science in the lay public. We want to promote science teaching by advising policy makers and political decision makers on science teaching reforms from primary schools to university. And we also want to have opinion and give advices on the initial and ongoing trainings of teachers. So the fourth mission is to foster international collaboration through BI and multilateral cooperation, to belong to international networks of academies, and to represent France with international scientific institutions. So the last role of the academy is really to provide to the French public authorities, or on their demand or on our own initiative, the conclusion of the academy science analytical reports, notes and recommendations, and expertise. So with that, I would like to give the stage to Eric Orsena, and I would like to thank the team of the Academy for organizing such a beautiful meeting with us. I would like to thank Bernard Dujon and Michel Delceni, because I think we have a very nice program. And thank the speakers to have come for one of them from very far. And I am sure that this is an early beginning, and all the registered people will arrive slowly but surely. So thank you very much.
Thank you. Don't worry. I'll be short. And I'll be short because I am an ignorant. The point is, I am on the chair of Louis Pasteur, the French Academy. And during 12 years, I have a neighbor who was François Jacob, the Nobel Prize. And each week, each Thursday, he told me, you should be ashamed to be on this seat. Because as an economist, you know nothing about real life. So try a little bit to learn a little bit. So you are not able to be a scientist, but perhaps as a writer, you could write the biography of Pasteur. So I try to write this biography of Pasteur, and now I am working on mosquitoes. So I discover elsewhere than in political field, the reality of symbiosis and cohabitation. So I'm very happy to be with you, and thank you to pursue my education later is better than never. Thank you. I give the floor to dear Michel.
Good morning, everybody. It's a pleasure for me to welcome you here to this colloquium and to chair this session with Eric Orsena. I am actually a plant molecular biologist and working on plant genomes. We organized this program with Pascal and Bernard with talks on plants and invertebrates this morning, and this afternoon we'll have talks on microbiota role in mammalian and human. So we will talk on not very much on plant science, because you know that the most well-known symbiosis is the symbiosis between rhizobia and leguminose. But just the same day, there is a very nice meeting in Orsay dedicated to Adam Connorsi, who was a father of the signaling between rhizobia and legumes. So most of the plant science speakers were there, so we decided to have other aspects of the symbiosis.
You could improve cohabitation.
Yes. So I will not say any more, but just introduce the first speaker, who is Denis Allemand. He is from the Scientific Center in Monaco, and he is a professor in the Nice University. And he will talk on the topic, on the following topic: how does an animal behave like a plant, physiological and molecular adaptation of Zooxanthella and their host to symbiosis. Denis.